ago, we were in Alaska, and now we're heading out to the Bahamas. We're gonna celebrate my birthday and the anniversary of marriage. We've been married 15 years, and we're only gonna go for a couple days. Then we arrive back. We'll work about another week or so, and then we're heading out for a hike out in Kings Canyon in California. So I have so much to edit and put together. Anyway, stay tuned.
Your safety is our business. Please
So
help us
they
help
change our
you. If
gates.
you see
Now we're
something,
here on
say
this one.
something. Report suspicious activity to the
So
nearest
we're
law
gonna be going
enforcement
north,
officer, TSA
Eurythra.
officer, or airline representative.
Departing at 2:45, I think. We got a board on this plane from the outside. Kind of weird.
Been secured. The cabin light.
In order to get to this island. All right, so we finally made it to the resort. We have a swimming pool there, beach on the other side of this. There is a bar here, our view. We have a porch, our room. We just came in. This is our room. Got a small fridge. And then in the bathroom, let's see if I can get some light in here. This is our bathroom. We have a safe, the commode, and a shower. The time here right now is 5:58, and we're gonna see if we can go out and get something to eat. Been a long day. Our travel based on getting here was driving from Fort Myers to Fort Lauderdale, grabbing a prop plane from there, arriving here, getting a taxi to the ferry, taking a ferry over to the island, then getting another taxi to get to the resort, and now we have a golf cart just to kind of island. This island's really small, so it's not much to it. It's simple. So this is how we're getting around, using a, right here?
No.
We're using a golf cart. Drive around, otherwise we'll be walking the island. So we're gonna be here having breakfast. So we're just driving around exploring. Here's a view of the ocean there, and there is actually a bar somewhere back there, just can't get to it. So I am gonna back up this golf cart and see if we can get in there. So there's a marina bar down here. It's a tree house there, look.
Yeah. Okay, we can find a way to park right there. Go through here.
Yeah, this is a pretty marina here. This water is crystal clear. I mean, I don't know if my camera can pick up the bottom here, but yeah, look at that yacht. So we're just driving around looking for places to see. This is the beach. It's called Pink Sand Beach. And you basically swim at your own risk. There's no lifeguards here. The thing about us, we have the opportunity of swimming in our own beach area. But look how nice this looks. Very nice. So this is the way down to the beach. Nobody really utilizes the pool, but why would you use the pool when you got the beachfront? So this is the beach area that we're at. The resort's back there. It is beautiful. I'm gonna try to walk here in the water. I doubt very much you're gonna see much as far as the bottom goes. Water's warm. I'm not gonna go in now because I have the keys to the our room and I don't wanna lose them. So let me leave those keys back in the bag and then try to get back out here again. Best time to do is to come here. It's off season. It's not that many people and the prices are a little cheaper to be here. Grand Harbor is beautiful. It's a small island. There's not a whole lot to do here except what I'm about to show you now. So you'll lose my my voice on at some point here because I got to bring my GoPro way up on my selfie sticks. I don't want the lens to get wet. But man, I tell you, this water here is crystal clear. It's warm. The water's warm. How pretty is this? Wiping down there. This might be a copyright infringement with YouTube, but I have no control over it. It's just the phone playing. But I just wanted to tell you guys that we've been drinking Tito with some island juice. Putting them in these cups. Here we got ice. Or somewhat ice, yep. Anyway, we're about to head out. There is a bar for happy hours, I believe. And dinner at 7:30. We have been all day at the beach swimming, kind of a little burn, have some red skin. We have been enjoying our time here. And what I can say about Harbor Island is that the best time to come here is off season. And the only reason I tell you this is because there are not that many tourists here. If you come at the peak time, because this is actually off peak time, it will be a lot harder to, I guess, move about in this island. Restaurants, all the restaurants will be open. Right now, you're limited to restaurants here, but I really don't care. It's all about the experience, Haim. And I have to say that this resort that we're in has been great. I can't say more about the, you know, Harbor Island itself. You know, if you're gonna come here, I highly recommend the off season and you get to do a lot more. Definitely rent a golf cart. I believe it's like $55 a day, which I think is worth it. You get to do a lot with it and see, and you don't want to be walking around this island when it's hot. It really, things are not as close. Once again, what I said about traveling this island, I highly recommend you guys, if you do come, do a golf cart. You don't want to walk. The other thing too that I wasn't familiar with, because I don't own one of these things, and I actually have never driven one. So this has an emergency, or what they call a brake pedal. And it's locked right now, so it doesn't go anywhere. So there's two things you need to do here. To release this, you push all the way down on the gas pedal. Key in to turn on. Look at this part. You have a reverse lever. You'll hear it beep and we're off. So now we're in the opposite side of where we were. So this is considered the bay, and we're gonna have Italian food. I hear this is really good place to eat, so we're gonna give it a whirl. So the name of this place is called Acquapazza, and because we're off season, the tables are empty, so that's the nice thing about this place. All right, so this is the inside of the restaurant. We just made our order. We're having a pineapple vodka drink. My lovely wife. Love her to death. And like I said, off season, so there are not a lot of people here. So I'm having the grouper, blackened grouper with mashed potatoes and balsamic tomato salad with vegetable, and it is outstanding. And my wife is having the grilled octopus with spaghetti and cooked in the olive oil with tomatoes. Also outstanding. So we're just walking the marina here and kind of checking out what's here. Look how clear that water is. It's amazing. It's beautiful. My wife has been trying to convince me to go and fish, but there'll be time for that. I really want to just enjoy the time with her here and spend the time of eating the food and enjoying the sights, you know. We'll be back to this place, and when I do, I will be fishing. Okay, so we were here earlier this morning. This is that really nice marina. It's called, I think it's called Billarland Marina, I think it's called. I'm not too sure, but anyway, we're here. We're gonna stop here at the bar and have a drink. We just got back from that other marina. Just kind of crossed over with the golf course. This is the bar to this Billarland Club. Lots of goodies. I am gonna have sunny days. Man, what a pretty drink. Sunny days. All right, so I never really post anything as far as bathroom goes, but I have to say this is a beautiful bathroom and it smells incredibly good. So the sink has kind of a funky texture, but check this mirror out. Look at this mirror. It's all shells. So we're here. Gusty. 9:12. This place opens at 9 o'clock. More drinks. Pretty cool. Oh, and I left my golf cart parked out in the street there. Oh yeah, it's happening. So Gusty, who's the owner of this place, lost his wife 8 months ago, and he has not had opened this place. He's slowly starting to get back to that. He had very close ties with his wife. They were married for over 30 some odd years, and we were lucky enough to catch this day to be here and have a drink. And I have to say that he's got a good establishment here. The inside of the bar is pretty cool. It has, if you look at the floor, it has sand, kind of unique. I've only seen something like this in the Keys, so, but close tomorrow, and we were lucky enough to come here because we leave Monday and we have not been able to see this. But tonight we're kind of on a mission, try to do as much as we can, and you know, tomorrow's another day, we'll roll it out. But I highly recommend Gusty if you're ever in Harbor Island. He's a man full of wealth of knowledge about the people he's met in his time. His bar has tons of pictures of all the people that have become friends, and he knows them pretty much by face and name. So I am just talking to a captain. I call him Captain T. He charters here if you are interested in doing any kind of fishing, lobstering, diving. He's the man at sea. His vessel is the one with the two engines, the twin engines here. Really nice guy, and basically tells you what, you know, what runs during the season. This is our third day. We leave tomorrow, so we're kind of now dwindling down on what we're doing. But I gotta show you something here that I thought was kind of amazing. There's a Boston Whaler that has seen better days in its time, but it's still being used. But look at all the foam that is inside of that thing. I guess what they call unsinkable. look at the fish down there. I don't know. Oh, they're bonefish. Check it out. Look at the size of those bonefish. Wow. That's amazing. I have not seen bonefish as big as these. That is so cool.